Hi guys, it's Toddy here from Recombu, and this is the Samsung Galaxy S8, which of course we've already gone hands-on with in great detail, so we know exactly what this phone is all about, but we're going to unbox this version for you so you know what you can expect in box when you pick up the phone yourself at the tail end of April. So the box itself is very similar to last year's S7 and S7 Edge box. It's even more minimalist in many ways, mainly because it just says S8 on the front with the Samsung Galaxy S8 up in the corner here. Around the sides, there's nothing really to speak of. And on the back, there's a little bit of detail about the kind of design of the screen, the size of the screen, the fact it's got that Quad HD Plus Super AMOLED panel going on, the dual pixel focus 12-megapixel camera, and the like. But I'll get into that once we actually have the phone out of the box. So if I just pull the sleeve off there, that's basically it. This is the 64GB model. There might be a larger model down the line, but right now this is the only storage option that Samsung is offering the phone in. And then if I pull this lid up here, so there is the phone itself. This is the midnight black option. There are three colorways. There's the orchid gray, which is kind of like a purpley hue, and an arctic silver. But all three phones actually feature the same black frontage around the new display because its designs are basically given an almost borderless appearance, especially when it's off like this. On the back is just the like back cover with an IMEI. So I'll just peel that away. That's gone. I'll peel that off later and just see if it's got some charge. Wow, it's a very tall, thin phone, as you would have seen from the hands-on, but it feels great in the hand. It feels incredibly thin considering its size and that screen size as well. That unique aspect ratio there, which I believe is 18.5 by 9, if I remember correctly. Then under that is just a plastic tray. Nothing crazy there. And then we have, now, if I'm not mistaken, this one doesn't actually have, and it does have information in it. So this one comes with the quick start guide. There will also be a warranty guide, obviously, once this hits stores. But this just kind of shows you everything you need to know. Getting in there, some of the things that you get in box, how to install this SIM card, and obvious things like that, powering it up. And yeah, some safety stuff in the back as well. Don't dispose of the battery in the bin. There's a SIM tool as well, of course, which looks like a pretty standard one, nothing crazy. The eject pin, as they call it there. And then in the box itself, there's actually a few pieces. Now, you might notice this isn't the UK model. It's a European one, so you do get a European charger. Samsung has actually provided us with a UK equivalent of this, but it's just the same adaptive fast charger that we've seen before. It doesn't appear to be any difference in voltage or amperage from initial inspection, so you should get the same fast charging capabilities as you would if you used an older charger from, say, last year's S7. But you get the adapter. Then you actually get a couple of adapters in box and USB. So the phone now is Type-C. So this is the first flagship after the Note 7 to sport Type-C USB connection. On the back, it's a USB-A to USB-C. So if you want to charge or make a data transfer, so it's a USB connector, then you have that. And that's wrapped up in its own little cellophane. And then we have this little guy, which is a USB-C to USB micro USB. So again, I guess if you want to use maybe the old USB, micro USB cable, you can use this adapter instead. So you have plenty of adapters in box, which is great. And I believe if you pick up the Gear VR, which is now designed to support the Galaxy S8, it also comes with an adapter too. Then under here, we have a couple of pieces. We have the charging cable. So this is the USB-A to USB-C cable in black to match the phone. I think it, no matter what color you go for, you get a black cable. And then we have the headphones. Now the headphones are something that Samsung was really proud about at launch because they are tuned by, as you can see, their AKG. So they're quite premium headphones, should offer some pretty decent sound. The phone does still have a 3.5mm headphone jack. So these ones, if I just unbundle these, you can see they've got a nylon cord, so they are kind of extra durable if the camera can focus on that, with a just a standard 3.5mm jack on the end there. And these are in-ear buds, and they do have an inline remote somewhere, if I can find it. There it is. So that is also protected by some telephone by the looks of it. But you've got a mic on the back, you've got a three-button operation, so it looks like you've got pause and play controls, as well as volume control there too. And obviously you can use this to make and take calls too. So that is nice, and these should offer better than your average in-ear audio experience if you like your tunes. And also I did spot in the box, I don't know where I've put it now, but there was also, yeah, there you go, extra buds in case you have a different ear size. There are lots of different ear shapes and sizes there. So that is everything that the Galaxy S8 comes with in box. We're now going to just jump through the setup process and I'll talk a little bit more about the phone. Okay, so we've just gone like shot through the setup process. Oh, and as you can see, it's now pulling in all of the emails and everything. I've just put my account on there. I haven't done anything like and then the Samsung account, which it does offer during setup, and the benefits of that are kind of Samsung app access and a few other features, obviously Bixby integration as well. And if I actually swipe to the right, you actually do have Bixby here, which is the new voice assistant, or digital assistant, I should say. It's not just voice. That kind of covers the whole software experience on the Galaxy S8. And beyond that, the UI is a new UI, new icon design, new layout to kind of match the aesthetic of the phone. It's quite heavy-handed, I'd say, but it's quite nice all the same. It's a matter of preference. You have the edge screen here, which obviously I haven't set up yet, but edge panels are there, much like on the S7 Edge, I should say. And then you even have the option to like switch content from your old device, which is something that you found on previous Samsung phones too. But that is essentially everything that the Galaxy S8 does during boot up. But what we're looking at here is, as I've said before, a 5.8 inch Super AMOLED Plus display, Quad HD Plus, excuse me, display. It's a 5.8 inch panel with that, I think it's 18.5 by 9 aspect ratio, which gives it this tall, thin appearance, but it looks really good. Both edges are curved on both the S8 and the S8 Plus. And now obviously the physical buttons from the S7 Edge have now gone, and now you have these on-screen buttons, and the fingerprint sensor is at the back. But there's also iris recognition and facial recognition at the top, so this is actually set up to unlock with my face as well. So if I wake the phone up from lock, maybe it'll wake up. Maybe not. Can't see my face right now, but I am craning around the camera. But yeah, and on the inside, it's powered by, in Europe at least, it's powered by Samsung's own Exynos, is it 8895 processor. Whilst in the US, it's the Qualcomm Snapdragon 835, the 4 GB of RAM, 64 GB of internal storage, 3000 mAh battery with Samsung's own adaptive fast charge tech, 256 microSD expandability, dual SIM in some countries as well, 12 megapixel camera with dual focus pixels, single LED flash, heart rate sensor, 8 megapixel front facer with the same dual pixel technology apparently. And that is kind of just firing off the specs right now, but obviously if you want to know more, we will have plenty more on this phone very, very soon. But that is unboxing the Samsung Galaxy S8. If you have any questions about this phone beyond that, you can drop us a line down below in the comments. The phone is going to be available on the 20th of April in the UK for £689 off contract. So it's a pretty expensive handset. But don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel for more, and thanks for watching.